Hi guys, today I will present you a bruschetta recipe. It's very easy to do. It's so good when you have some friends that come into your club, to your house, and it's a very easy recipe, faster, and let's go. You need melted butter, tomatoes, pepper, jam, cheese, olive oil, parmesan cheese, soy sauce, garlic salt, and salt. So, let's start. First of all, we have the tomatoes. We have to chop the tomatoes in small pieces, like this. You can do it in a big pieces, small as, depends that you like. I like sometimes big pieces of tomato, like this, or sometimes small ones. I have no problem with that. We use the tomato because they give the acidity to the recipe. They are so rich in flavor, and they are really, really lovely. And they give a color so cute when you have the recipe completed. Okay, we cut the two tomatoes, and we pass the tomatoes to a pan that is in the stove. We set up the fire in the little one, and we put a little bit of oil.
This is a little salt.
A little bit of salt. I like when the salt burns in the pan. They are really good. And a few cups of garlic salt and soy.
Garlic sauce and soy.
Pan, and we cook this a few minutes. Very slow fire. We don't have to hurry this. We get this small fire. Very easy. And we have to find a spoon to remove our recipe. Delicious. Okay. Well. Start the mix for the bruschettas. This is my personal recipe. There are a lot of recipes to make bruschettas. This is a little bit more unhealthy, but it's so good. So, we have melted butter. To this melted butter, we will mix with Parmesan cheese. A good amount. I just like 2 or 3 spoons of coffee, like this. And we start to mix the butter. Delicious. The Parmesan cheese is really salty, so we don't have to use any other. We don't need to use salt or soy salt to give a flavor to the recipe, okay? We leave this here and we have to check our tomatoes. The other oven. This is a grill to cook our bruschetta. It's ready. And this is a small pan with some peppers that I already chopped into the onions. I use the green one because the tomatoes are red and I like the food with a lot of colors. Okay?
So it is basically to get better colors, more colors.
Yes, and this is just for give us some piece of another vegetable, and it looks really good. Okay, we set fire to everything, so we will put a little bit of soy salt, olive oil in this too, but just a little bit because this is just for grilling the peppers. The tomatoes are really good. We need to put a little bit of salt and soy salt again. Amount of salt. If you like the tomatoes, if you like the acidity of the tomatoes, and a lot, if you feel that they are not the acidity enough for you, you can give us a little bit of lemon juice to this recipe. Everything is going great.
So So you don't, you guys don't know how really, really good it smells now. Yeah, it starts smells like I need to eat this as soon as it is done.
So we put a little salt with this olive oil, and we put the peppers in this pan. Listen, it's hot already. So we'll start to, put the peppers. We need another spoon. We can use the same one because it's not good for the recipe. Everything has to be clean, and everything has to use for 1 or 2. Nice. Like me, I like garlic, so I use garlic.
Garlic sauce?
Garlic in everything. You put a little amount of garlic in the recipe. It starts to smell. It's quite delicious, okay?
Yeah.
We will put this like 4, 5, 6, so 10 minutes. That's the way that you like to cook it. If you like, there is a little bit crunch. You cook like 5 to 6 minutes. If you like a soft pepper, like 10 to 15 minutes. You will see, they will start to put a little bit brown. The consistency will change. Okay? Our tomatoes are really good. They are cooking in slow. But the tomatoes will burn because they have a little bit juicy. Remember, at the beginning the tomatoes were hard, so they start all the juices. Some people like the seed. I don't have any problem with that. Okay? So we have to try the salt. Hey guys, welcome again to my kitchen. So in the last episode, okay, we were cooking the peppers and the tomatoes. Now I like to give a little bit of butter to the peppers because the butter, it has a little bit of grace, and they give it to the peppers, I don't know, like a very good aspect, like brilliant and very soft, and it's a little bit salty, and it gives a little bit of flavor. So it's time to put this here, and he will be melted. A little bit of a teaspoon of butter. This will give you a very lovely flavor and a lot of
smell.
No, yes. Flavor, a very lovely. So the tomatoes are cooking very good. You can see this. All the juices are really good. You can smell the salt, the soy, and the garlic in the salt. Jam and a little bit of cheese. I use this in the bottom of the bread. I cut this in the middle, and now another cut in the middle too, to give it like 4 cuts. So you will have this, and I do the same with the cheese. This cheese is like a white cheese with a little bit of cheddar cheese, but not as strong. Now, for the bruschetta, we have a loaf of bread. I prefer use white bread. You can use brown bread, diet bread, paleo bread, any kind of bread if you want, okay? You can use small bread, like a sandwich bread. There's no problem. So, I have a little loaf. I already cut 6 slices of bread. Look at this, they are beautiful. This bread is really fresh. It's recent all baking. So I have these beautiful slices of bread. If you want big slices, there's any problem with that. If you have small slices, you can do any kind of slice of bread that you like. I used to cut this bread like 1 or 2 inches. But you can cut it like smallest pieces, you know, like a little bit. If you like more thin, you can cut it thinner. So let's see how the tomato is going. It's perfect. Look at this. They have very good flavor. I think the salt is okay, so we will try this. You got the pulp, the new one. A little bit. It's really good. Just need a little bit of salt. A small amount. We don't like that the food, it would be salty because it's very important. And we start again to move it. I think in 5-6 minutes they will be okay. Now, let's see our peppers. Our peppers are looking very good because the way they are doing, they are a little bit brown. I like when they are a little bit crunchy but not too much, because I rather to eat this cooking. Because remember that sometimes the red pepper is a little bit sour. So I think when you cook a little bit more, its flavor is more, you know, sweet. It might prefer, or I rather to give it this, like a little teaspoon of sugar, because they are like sour and sweet, and they are so good sometimes. Okay, we have the bread. You remember the mix that we made before? A little bit of butter with Parmesan cheese. This is excellent. Now, with a knife, we will have a little bit of bread, a piece of bread. And we will cover the bread with this mixture. You can give us the quantity that you want about this mixture. There is no problem if you give a lot of this, or just a little bit. It depends that you like. But you will cover this for the two sizes, not just for this one. And you will cover this for this size too, because you want to give it the flavor of the butter with the Parmesan, a little bit salty, and it's so rich of flavor from the butter. I really love the butter. So we have this for the two sizes, and you will cook for the two sizes, okay? We'll put this and we'll do the same to the other breads. We don't have any problem with that. The body is shiny, they have the excellent amount of Parmesan. If you don't like Parmesan, you can use another type of cheese like this, or cheese like, I don't know, mozzarella, maybe, but it will taste the same, but it's okay. Not everybody likes Parmesan. Okay, you can see this, and we'll continue doing with the others later. So, we have a pan. Our pan is with the fire very, very, very slow fire. Not too much, because we don't want to burn the bread. So look at the sauce, it's almost ready. The tomato is perfectly cooked. You can see the pieces, they are breaking apart. They are like a chunky. It's very, you can see that it's, when you look at it, it's really like a chutney, because you have sauce, then you have pieces of tomato, so it's perfect. Our peppers are cooking excellent well. Now they are already turning brown, that's the way that we want. So great, you can see this, it's really great. Now we put our bread in the grill. We don't need to use any kind of oil, because we already have butter, and the butter is oil enough.
Look at this, this smells great. It looks great, it smells great. Okay. I think I'm gonna eat something really delicious today.
Well,
you're gonna have really something really delicious at the end of this video. You might be able to do it.
So, let's see. The peppers are perfect, so we'll turn off the heat. And we will shake the pan. So we put all the breads into the grill. I have a big family and everybody likes to eat this. So it's not easy when you do that, and don't give it a little bit to everyone. Let's see. I change the bread side to side to
you,
see.
You flip it up.
Exactly. To see, it's very good, it's very raisin. So, we will wait and this gives a now, we're gonna play to the dish.
Look at this, we have a Christmas plate. That is pretty good.
Well guys, I love the Christmas season, so I will use this. We have the jam, the cheese, I have the tomatoes are ready, the pepper is ready. So we just wait for the bread. Then we'll another table because it's already used. So wait a moment, please. Perfect.
We would like to point this that the tomatoes are a bit juicy, but not that much, okay?
Okay, let's check our bread. Wonderful.
Look at that.
Wonderful, you can see the bread in the bread. It's so thin. If you like a little bit more crunchy, you can give the skin some more time. These are the bread that we had before. It's not cooked yet, so we will wait. Sometimes if you like, I go to the fridge. Hey guys, try to find a little bit of lettuce because the lettuce is really healthy and it's green. And I will cut a little bit to the companion for my bread. I have a few ones. Watch my lettuce. Now I put the lettuce in the table and I try to find a little bit of balsamic vinegar and I spray a little bit in the lettuce. I love the balsamic vinegar.
Okay, that's good.
And I will cut this in little spaces. Just a little bit pieces. Like this. Great. They don't need salt if you want to put a little bit of pepper, like me. Or any kind. Paprika is really good too. A little bit of cayenne. Well, let's see our wraps. They are lovely. Oh, this is a little bit. Okay. Take pieces. And now we have our beautiful bread here. They are really crispy. They are really delicious. These are cooking yet. They need a little bit more time. So, we will unplate. Let's turn up the fire a little bit. Perfect. They are perfect. Look at these. Delicious and it smells delicious. Oh, wonderful, don't you think? Now, let's go to unplate our dish. First, we put the bread. You can use this part or this part. It depends what you like. If you like a little bit more, like with color, you use this. Perfect. And now, with a spoon, we put a little bit of tomato. And just pour the tomato into the bread. Bread. It will give you the acidity that you need. Then you put the cheese because it will melt with the heat of the tomato. Two pieces or three, it depends what you like. Then the jam. You can use two slices too. There's no problem with that. After this, we will use this part. a little bit of lettuce. If you like a big amount of lettuce, put a little bit of lettuce. Remember, you can put balsamic soil, you can use another, and two little pieces of pepper into milk. It will give you a lovely taste. If the bread is big, you can use 2-3 slices, it depends on your taste. And voila, there is cheese.